and then join here friends playing beach handball, and now he's starting player of Spanish national team for Bayer. Once again, it will be repeated. Referee to Wanderson Oliveira to get the ball. Third possession for Spain. That's not of course.
First possession for Spain, number 13, as specialist Espada Carillo. Good assist and goal for Luis Mosquera.
Domingo is left-handed player, he's playing on the pivot. That's a specific tactical option for the Spanish team. Maybe it will make some problem for Qatarians. Don't forget, Qatarian team lost first two match in the first period, but later won in shootout.
Also, Tilkrad is a specialist for Qatar team. Mutasem on the right wing.
Yeah, Mutasem Mohamed missed that spin shot, so Spain leads 2-0. Number 18, Team Spain, Vasquez Diz Chispi, very famous, one of the best scorers in the history of beach handball.
And this is a goal from Mosquera. Sorry for Espada Carillo.
2 points, Spain lead 4-0.
Qatar is in attack. Number 8, Hassan. Great assist, Hassan here, a great position. This will be penalty shot.
6 meter shot, contact in defending block. With Mohamed Hassan, most experienced player of Qatarian team. Probably he will execute the 6 meter throw.
Six-meter shot for Mohamed Hassan. Yes, that's first goal for Qatar in this match. 4-2, Spanish lead.
Similar tactical solution in both teams with a specialist on the sideline of their team, but Qatarian attack with the four players in the line, while Spanish team has pivot, and one specific fact is that pivot is left-handed.
Great save from Garba. Spain team in attack, four assists, but still in Spanish possession.
Very passive play of Spanish team. So probably after a few passes we will go to the passive play. Yes, immediately.
Great assist, but brilliant save from Ali Garba.
Ali Garba just keeps saving like he started in previous matches with a lot of saves. Great performance. Very important weapon in defense of the Qatarian team.
That's a good assist and score for number 17.
Mutasem Mohamed. Spanish defense is more open on the left side of the opponent attack, you know, because to raise on that side, so it's very difficult to overcome. Look at this, four players of Spanish team, mistake, one player will, so Touré stay
this
out.
Will be exclusion, too many players on the court.
Yeah. Very strange for such experienced team. Touré enter the court as fourth. He will stay with suspension out, and Chispi went out, so they will play with two players against four.
Great chance for Qatar to score the goal.
Passive play, warning signal.
Good assist, but easily saved from Fuentes.
The fact that Touré gets first suspension could be very dangerous for Spanish defense, because normally he's making contact in defending blocks. However, De Vargas, 2 points for Spain, and the warning signal for Kanikaki not to pretend, not to float during the opponent attack. Khaled Hassan, coach of Qatar team, is very angry with his players.
That was an easy possession for Al-Saltiakrat, but he missed that shot. He hit the post.
Spain leads 6-4 after 4 minutes. Chispi and 6 meter throw, probably suspension as well. No, inside lock.
You know, we also yesterday had some problems with defense from 6 meters area.
It's not his problem in defense, that's more problem of attacking players made the problems because of their great performance. But however, one more great save by Ali Garba.
Chance for Qatar to tie the game. Al-Saltiakrat now, that's good shot and score for Qatarian specialist.
Equalized at 6, Spain and Qatar.
Great goal from
De Vargas.
Cervera Perez. Cervera Perez De Vargas. Yeah.
2 points after spectacular spin shot. That is one of characteristics of his play. Four players, Mohamed. Great. Hassan Mohamed, 2 points. Most experienced player, grandfather of Qatarian team. It's necessary to say, very passive play in attack of Spanish team.
It seems like they have problems, but great assist. And wow. beautiful goal for
number 97, Domingo Luis Mosquera.
Once again, Spain in the lead, but not for long time. Al-Saltiakrat, number 95, as a specialist, his goal is for 2 points.
Goal number three, no?
Number two.
4 minutes to go. 10-10.
And now great shot on the other side from Espada Carrillo.
Spain again in the lead. And Qatarian team remain with the same tactic with the four players in the line, attacking directly to the opponent's defense. Easily solution for Hassan Mohamed, but no goal.
Poor shot from Hassan. And now Spain have a chance to take seriously. Perez de Vargas, that was offensive foul from Vasquez Diz. Qatar on the attack, a lot of space, and easily score from Mutasem Mohamed.
Possession remains for Spain, but you can see that when they play with Touré in defense on the right side of Spanish defense, goalkeeper choose the short angle of his goal, and then it repeat many times already.
It will be exciting in the finish of the first period. Great goal. Fantastic shot from Espada Carrillo.
14-12 for Spain, 2:25 until the end of the first period. We will repeat, this match is very important for Spanish team. Wow, that was Er Mutase Mohamed.
And first turnover for Spanish team. Huge mistake from goalkeeper. From Fuentes Zamora. And Qatar now can take the lead. Hassan. Turnover for Qatar. And Spanish team will try to score a goal on the other side.
Spanish is playing with three changes in defense offense. All three players go out and the other go in. While in Qatar, penalty, suspension, no suspension, excuse me. But a warning for
Mutasem Mohamed.
De Vargas for two from 6 meter throw. Great.
Off the woodwork.
Kill the spider.
Yeah. Till the end of first period. Very important attack for Qatar. Hasabala is now a specialist for Qatar. Hasabala. Malash score for number 17, Mutasem Mohamed. Last minute of first period. Severa Perez de Vargas, it was a foul. Foul for Sid Kenawi.
It's really rare to see the player play it with ring, so.
That was a clear offensive foul.
And that it happened in the moment when Spain was with four players in Qatar for that. Change of the player just with two. 16-16, 29 seconds. Both teams have team timeouts. Khaled Hassan has his green timeout paper in the hand. 22 seconds.
Now Malash is a specialist.
And for the first time in the middle of the court. So they will look for the solution probably through Hani Kaki on the right side, left-handed, maybe immediately. No timeout for Qatar. 60 seconds to go. Enough time for one Spanish attack probably after the shoot. So 9.5 minutes, Qatarian team played with a specialist on the sideline of their substitution zone, but now they decided to push Hani Kaki in the game. So far the best scorer of Qatarian team, left-handed spectacular player, number 90.
Spanish statistics, 8 of 12 from the field.
3 turnovers and 3 saves. We will see, will Osborne use service of Toure in the last? No, without Toure in defense.
Seconds to go, 16-0, and now we'll see.
Change in the Qatarian team, Mahmoud Hasabala will be on the specialist position. 12 seconds.
Hasabala, great assist, great chance and great miss. Spanish team now have 2 seconds to score the goal. Try, but
no goal.
That was too far from goal. 16-0, we will wait for the golden goal.
Golden goal, the match but will Spain, be restarted immediately.
But Spain is in a huge advantage here because of Toure.
Yeah, we will see, we will see. Because 2.6 meters, that's really...
Toure guarantees possession, but we'll see.
Venderson Oliveira leave the ball and ball go to possession of the Qatarian team, as I told you.
Misunderstanding yes. Between Spanish players. Toure get the ball, but not for Spanish team. And now the chance for Qatar. They won the first period.
Kaki. First points in this match of the best scorer of Qatarian team. 17-16. Qatar is in the lead.
Huge celebration here at Al Garrafa Beach Complex. It's like a party here.
Yes, let's check results on the application of the games. Croatia at the moment lose against Hungary 10-12. While Uruguay is leading 8-4 against Tunisia. Uruguay need victory to be able to compete for the fourth place. But as well, Spain need to win and Croatia need to win against Hungary. At the moment, Qatar 8 points, Croatia 6, Hungary and Spain need 4 points, and Uruguay 2. At the bottom of the ranking, Tunisia without points.
Five minutes of rest and we are waiting for a second period.
One more great match on the Al Gharafa Beach Hammer Complex. We are not able to see many of the matches on the court 2 and court 3 with a lot of great teams. Ready to restart of the match in second period. We are waiting for Qatarian boys. At the moment, Croatia lose against Hungary 21-18. And Uruguay lead 10-4 against Tunisia. Hungarian team won first period against Croatia. They lead 1-0. They need victory to stay in the quarterfinal, to be in the quarterfinal. Uruguay won against Tunisia in the first period. Against Hagi Ture and Mutase Mohamed on the opposite side. 26 centimeters of difference.
Second period started. Ball from Spain.
Number 5 of Bento Castro Duarte. Two easy points for the Spain. Spain in the lead.
Now with number 25 on specialist position is Malash for Qatar. Bad shot from Hassan straight to the Amerigo Fernandez. Easily saved for Spanish keeper.
Spanish in both teams now are playing with the specialist in the middle of the court. So it means a lot of possibility for the in-flight.
Misunderstanding of two Spanish players.
Hani Kaki, left-handed player of Qatarian team on the pivot position. So probably there will be more passes from Mohamed Hassan. Yes, it starts. 2 points.
Goal for Hani Kaki. He scored a decisive goal in the first period. Castro Duarte, Luis Mosquera, Castro Duarte from 7 meters over the bar. Qatar on the attack, 25, Malash. Great assist.
Improvisation
from Hassan and score for Kaki.
And now for sure Qatarian team, they show to Spanish team that what is the most dangerous weapon in the attack. So probably there will be some longer pass to the right wing in the following attack.
And now Severa Perez de Vargas hit the post, but remain possession for Spain.
Rashid Youssouf on the goal of Qatarian team. Oh,
very bad assist.
Yeah, even Toure can't catch this ball.
Nobody in the world can catch this ball.
Toure on the right wing position in defense against Mohamed Hassan. Maybe not so good use of such defending capacity. Pass, and now, yes!
Alfa Pilkrat scored the goal for Qatar, 6-2.
It's always great stuff to have two left-handed players in the team, as the Qatarian team has two attractive moves.
And another goal from Kaki from counter-attack.
Yes, very rare to see Kaki on the left wing side, and he used that opportunity because he jumped and he didn't let Toure even to jump to defense.
Two easy saves for
look at the Youssouf. Game.
And one more time, easily goal for Hani Kaki.
Yes, 360, an almost passive play while he jumped. He take a lot of time.
This is a huge lead for Qatar. Very nice goal from Lopez Ortola.
Yes, and now he's shooting full strength. There is no option to try to do it with exhibition. Ball possession remained for Qatar. Chispi was in 6 meters zone, goalkeeper zone of his team. Brazilian referees are very precise with throw in.
Great save from Amerigo Fernandez.
Great support from Qatarian spectators.
Very important possession for Spain. Another one, great save from Rashid Youssouf. But it was a foul.
I can say decision selection of the Spanish team at that moment is not good. They need more pace and more patience in the attack.
Pace and space.
That's it.
This is a good shot.
Yeah, without any of that, they scored. So no pace, no space, but they scored. Fantastic for Spain. 10 against 6. Cut a lead.
Hassan. Great assist, but now Kahi is stopped by Amerigo Fernandez.
Those unserious shoot probably will be punished by other team, as it happened with Spanish team, and now the Qatarian repeat the same.
Tough, very tough position. One of the biggest miss that we saw in these days.
Yeah, but just because of the high humidity, because De Vargas is the great player and he normally scores from this spin shot.
That was a that was a penalty for Qatar.
Suspension for number 15. You can see it now. Suspension number 15, Antonio Varo Morilla and Hani Kaki on the 6-meter line for 2 points. He scored. And team timeout for Spain.
They'll need one.
Top teams and top players, but we must say, very high temperature here in Doha. It's not easy to play on such temperature and
you need to run fast because sand is too hot.
Oh, but it's difficult to do it. And this is the fifth round, so 3 matches in 3 days, so afternoon of Sunday will be free for the teams, and the team that will qualify, it will be qualified for the quarterfinal, will have morning off as well on Monday. So after this match, enough time to recover. Espada Carrillo, a specialist on the middle position.
Spain desperately need a goal from this possession, but that will be another attack for Spanish team. Number 5, Castro Duarte, another turnover for Spain. Qatar is a very good position right now to win this match. Over 3 minutes to go. And easy score for Mutazem Mohamed.
Qatari 46.
No, that was the wrong side of the net. But it was off the block.
No, especially stay injured or he's staying in the opponent goalkeeper zone. It was probably some small contact, and because
it would be Qatar possession.
Yes, it will be possession for goalkeeper of Qatar. Antonio Jesus Espada. Years. Yeah, he said that there were some contact with number 24, Sikenawi. against El Kenawi. We already know it's very quite tough defending player, so it could be. Now goalkeeper throw, and Qatarian team is playing with side specialist, one left-handed player on the pivot, and the guy that will decide this attack. Not decide, but he missed.
That was good position for
Qasem Mohamed,
but he missed that shot.
And just for one.
But 2.5 minutes to go.
There is still enough time, but the problem is the quality of the play of Spanish team.
Especially in offense.
Yeah, they didn't show too much so far.
Now this was a great shot from Ortola Lopez.
With a bit of luck to score the goal. We are almost in the last 2 minutes of the second period.
Rashid Yusuf made some saves already.
Yes,
on this lob shots.
Qatarians won 2 bronze medals on the World Championship 2016 and 14.
And they are reigning Asian champions.
Yes, and David,
fifth time in a row.
Yes. But on the global level, for sure, they will look to play in the final for the first time. And if they will play, Rashid will celebrate his birthday on Wednesday, on the final day.
That was painful hit for a Spanish player.
By Mahmoud Hasabala.
Exclusion for Hasabala.
Suspension, yes. First. 4-2 for Spanish team. Really strange choice of solution of Spanish team.
But that will be a penalty.
Yes. There were contact, but normally those contacts is like when it's 4-2, could be as well attacking foul. 2 points for Alberto Castro Duarte. 16-10 for Qatar, and ball possession in the last 80 seconds of the match.
Qatar players needs to be a patient.
Khaled Hassan, coach of the Qatarian team, has the team timeout as well in his possession. 2 points. It will be very difficult. Last minute, 8 points. Almost no solution for Spanish team to win this period. Steps and team timeout by Hassan Khaled. Egyptian coach that is leading.
It seems like
team.
It's all over in this match, that Qatar will win.
Match decided. Now we can look over to see what's happened on the other courts. In the second period, first won by Hungary, and in second period Hungary lead 24-20 against Croatia. Uruguay equalized at 6 in the second period against Tunisia, but that result will not be important anymore. Actually, Spain will lose, and it happened on the court, central court, which means Uruguay will stay on the 5th or even maybe 6th position. Uruguay need to win against Tunisia to be 5th. And Hungary with 2 more points will be 2nd. Spain 4th, Qatar 1st. Which means Qatar will play against Australia. Hungary will play against Sweden. And Croatia against Brazil. One more classical match in the quarterfinal. 2 points for Qatarian team. Kamal Aldin Malash. 35 seconds to go. 10 points difference. Everything decided. One more save by Rashid Yusuf. 25 years within 4 days.
20 seconds till the end. As expected, 5 wins for Qatar in this group. They played great these five matches. They had a lot of support here. And yes, it will be interesting in quarterfinals. They will play against Australia.
Match ended second period, 2010 from Qatar, 2-0, 2010, 17-16. Qatarian team won the Group B. They will play against Australia in the quarterfinal on Monday afternoon.